Welcome to Nature All Around Us. Did you know you can contribute to research happening at the museum? Well, you can, as a citizen scientist. Citizen science is when members of the public, people like you, collaborate with professionally trained scientists, like the researchers here at the museum. Anyone can do citizen science, no matter who you are, where you live, or whether or not you have a college degree. We need your help. Over the next few minutes, I'll tell you about three ways you can participate in studying the nature all around us. There might be a new squirrel in your neighborhood. In 2011, the fox squirrel was observed for the first time in Utah. This species of tree squirrel is native to the eastern and midwestern United States, but has been widely introduced to areas of the West. Fox squirrels are now living and spreading throughout portions of northern Utah. We don't know how they got here, or what the impact they have on the local ecosystem is. The museum's vertebrate zoology team are hoping to answer these questions and many more by studying these small mammals. Since squirrels often live near our homes and are frequently on the move, citizen scientists like you are the perfect people to help gather data. Here's how. First, find a squirrel. Fox squirrels are characterized by their big bushy tails, orange bellies, and bold behavior. They're excellent climbers and spend equal time in trees and on the ground. They differ in size and color from Utah's native tree squirrel species, the red squirrel. The native ground squirrel species, the rock squirrel, is similar in size but not as colorful and rarely climbs as it lives on and under the ground. Do you see squirrels in your neighborhood? If so, the museum wants to know about it. All you need to do is take a photo of any squirrel you see and upload it to iNaturalist, a free app that captures photos of plants and animals taken by citizen scientists. iNaturalist will help you identify what you took a picture of so you can learn what it is. Then your observation will be added to a global record of biodiversity, which helps professional scientists, like researchers at the museum, study plants and animals. Your photographs of Utah squirrels will provide real-time data on where and how quickly fox squirrels are expanding their range, and will help the museum better understand how they're impacting the ecosystem. The fox squirrel isn't the only introduced species that the Natural History Museum of Utah is studying. We're also interested in an insect called the European firebug. This small insect, native to Europe, looks very similar to a box elderbug, a red and black insect you likely see in big groups outside during the spring, summer, and fall. Unlike box elderbugs, European firebugs are not native to Utah, can't fly, and on closer inspection, have two black circles on their backs. Using your keen sense of observation, can you figure out which one is the European firebug? Believe it or not, the first time the European firebug was recorded in North America was right here in Utah in 2008. We don't know how they got here, but we do know they have been spreading and can now be found in other Western states in the US, as well as Canada and Mexico. The museum is eager to learn more about the spread of the European firebug in the US and their impact on the ecosystem. We are depending on citizen scientists to help find and photograph firebugs. To help, take a photo of any European firebug you see and post it to iNaturalist. Don't worry, these insects don't bite and are safe to handle and be around. Finally, the museum is studying an insect that people do not often think of in Utah, the firefly, also known as a lightning bug. If you're not familiar, these insects, which are actually beetles, give off light from their lower abdomen due to a chemical reaction called bioluminescence. Though we don't know much about them, fireflies have been observed in Utah. The museum even has a specimen that was collected in 1929. Are fireflies in the West the same as firefly species found in the eastern United States? Do they have genetic similarities? Where do they like to live? You can help the museum's Western Firefly Project answer these questions and more. Are you up for the challenge? Fireflies out west are tricky to find. They have a wide range and could be spotted in at least four different states, which is a lot of land for researchers to cover. The season to find them is short. They're only visible from May to June. We also know they tend to like areas with water, like wetlands, and don't start flashing until around 10 p.m. or later. Researchers at the museum can't look for fireflies everywhere they want to during this short season, so they depend on citizen scientists across the state and beyond to help look too. Kids and families have found new populations of fireflies right here in Utah that we never would have known about. this May and June, consider looking for fireflies with your families. You can report sightings by going to fireflies.nhmu.utah.edu and filling out the firefly sighting form. A museum researcher will be in touch with you after receiving the form and may drive out to have a look themselves. Check out the museum's website for more information on the project and to see a map of all the confirmed sighting locations. There might be a firefly near you. Every day, people just like you are helping contribute to science by being observant of their surroundings, recording observations, and sharing them with researchers on sites like iNaturalist. These people are citizen scientists, and they are making a difference in their communities. You can too. Citizen science starts at home, and I encourage you to connect with the nature all around you by exploring your own backyards, nearby parks, or even cracks in the sidewalk to look for species you could record. Be on the lookout for more ways you can help the Natural History Museum of Utah as a citizen scientist by checking out our website, nhmu.utah.edu/citizenscience. Happy observing!